Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to Terratech with me, Lathrix. And of course, welcome back to our lovely disorganized scrapyard, which is more and more looking like a tech graveyard in every single episode. In today's video, we are going to try our darndest to get to either level 5 with the regular faction to unlock their ultimate weapon, which apparently is a cannon on a turret, or we are going to get to level 3 with the Hawkeye reputation. Once we get to level 3 with Hawkeye, that is when we can finally build our combat flyer of our dreams, because at that point, we unlock, if we go into the flight blocks, the medium rotor, the large rotor, and of course, the rotor fan, in addition to the cannon turret, the cruise missile, the autocannon, and honestly, what looks the coolest, the Hawkeye Seeker missile pod. At this stage, we can possibly even make a helicopter. It's going to be very, very cool. Now, off camera, I did try my best to make a few different types of flyers. I built a little venture flyer, I built a little flyer with the Hawkeye stuff, and they just don't have many uses right now. The only use I can really get out of them is to go out into the field and find quests. And that's absolutely it. And then come back and then bring a proper tech to go and do the dirty work and kill all of the enemies. So, we are going to continue where we left off, doing the quests for the Hawkeye, and I'm going to do this one first, the Tech Hunter number 4. Simply kill 50 techs. I definitely prefer these, the ones in which you can just kill anything, because it's so, so much easier. That looks so, so painful. Also, I've added a second layer of wheels, which both adds a lot of armor and a fair bit of turning capability, and I've also added some guns on the side. So yes, we now have even more guns. I kind of forgot we put that on there. I've also unlocked some venture stuff, but nothing really too exciting, although some of the stuff was aerial-based, so that will definitely help when we can finally build a combat flyer. So right now, I am going to ignore building a little drone to follow us around, although so many people want to see that, and I keep on saying I'll do it. I just really want this flyer. The flyer is my ultimate goal. So, I'll be right back once I've killed some enemies or something exciting happens. I also need to find some invasions. Now that's going to detonate so hard. Hello, I have shotguns! Oh, that was lovely. I am really loving Terratech at the moment, as you can probably tell by the upload rate. Either way, I'll be back in just a second. Is he even hitting me? I don't think... Oh, now he is. Oi! And you're gone. So many shots! Our energy has been depleted, but it looks like we are going to win this. Either way, though, I need to back off big time. So many of those had shotguns. If I lost anything, I've lost one gun, and... No, I've lost several guns on this side, okay. I really wish railguns were a little bit easier to use. I have tried using them as a broadside in addition to loads more on the front, but honestly, I just can't get a good use out of them. In comparison to these rifles and the shotguns, they're just not quite as good. Also, fantastic timing there on the shotguns, and once again, the audio has simply disappeared because of how many shots we're shooting. And down goes the final enemy after hitting me one last time with a railgun shot. Okay, a little bit of repair work to do, but thankfully, the enemy, of course, were made out of the same stuff we're made out of. So let's just get repairing. I just stepped away from the computer for a quick moment because the phone just rang, and apparently there's an invasion. Just, there's an invasion, have fun. Okay, thanks a lot, Terratech. Thankfully, I'm currently being charged up. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have overestimated the power of the charger. How much power does this thing have? Oh, my black hole generator. Oh no, my black hole generator isn't being attacked. You go over there for a second. Oh, I may lose everything here. No, 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 no. You just die already. There we go, I've got power. Now I haven't. This is so bad. Oh, that was like the worst invasion ever. Oh, I lost so much derp. Oh my god, my cabin as well. The blood god was not with us today. Okay, so a bit of repair work needed. Was not prepared for that. Was not prepared at all. I thought, oh, it's okay. It's safe to answer the door. I've just killed all the enemies around here. I've just set up a little charging area. But no, I got attacked for about 5-10 seconds before getting back to the computer. And now I really realize I need to pause the game before stepping away. Oh, I've lost so many shotguns. That is so much glorious money lost. Okay, well, we just need to purchase some shotguns again. That's not too bad. I mean, I am kind of rich again now because I sold a tiny portion of all the scrap I had. Back in a second when I'm nice and repaired. Now I'm all repaired, I should mention something very briefly about the weapon we are going to unlock when we hit level 5 with the main faction. So this, if I get out the correct item, is the Megaton Cannon, or the Megaton Cannon. I can't remember how it's spelled, there it is either way. And earlier I said it was on a turret, which of course, in my eyes, simply means it can rotate. It's a rotating cannon, I believe, that can do a ridiculous amount of damage per shot. Of course, I do try to stay as spoiler-free as possible, but I do know that this is a fan favourite, and I can't wait to get my grubby little hands on it. But sadly, we do need to be level 5 with the GSO first, or at least, I believe we have to be level 5 to craft it, if you can craft it. We'll get it in the future eventually. Sadly though, no luck just yet getting it from drops. Now, have I repaired myself correctly? Guns on that side are correct. Guns... Oh, I see one problem. Can any of you notice it? I'll give you a second. This wheel's the wrong way around. Now, that won't really make a difference. I just think it kind of looks weird. I don't like weird-looking things. If they look special, then it's okay, but not weird. Come on, get the right rotation. Do I have to be on the next thing? I'm not good at building. I can put guns on things. Okay, so I was selecting the wrong connection points. I'm still a little bit derpy at this. Now, there's a very fast enemy there. Hello. Two ventures killing each other. That's interesting. Oh, almost all of its guns removed in a single shotgun blast. This is why we still use shotguns, even though we're clearly not meant to be close quarters. Well, I guess maybe we are, since we have shotguns, but probably easier if we went full-on ranged combat. Ooh, what's over there? That looks like a Christmas tree. Ahem. Thank you. Ooh, actually, rather than scrapping you later, we could put a couple of these onto our tech. At the moment, I have 3 of the Hawkeye fuel tanks at the bottom. Maybe that'd be worth it. I have this at the moment, which lasts ages, but maybe for a quick burst. Oh! Oh! It can spin! Is that a Christmas tree? Oh, yep, that is a Christmas tree of death. I hear they're the worst kind of Christmas trees. Wouldn't recommend them. Do I fight that? Do I just ignore it? What does it count as? Is this a quest? Wait, that's a base? It's my base now. Oh, okay. I didn't... Oh, wow. You can even control it. That's awesome. I am the Christmas tree of death. Oh, that is really, really cool. Also, I trust it to defend itself. I think that'll do absolutely fine. I wonder which corporation gave me that quest. Was it the Geocorp? Was it Venture? No, I'm guessing GSO. Oh, definitely GSO. All the loot is GSO. Well, I'll go and kill the little guys around here, and then our quest continues to kill 50 techs. We're about halfway now, and very close to leveling up our Hawkeye. Fine then, run! Don't love me. What on earth is that? That is another base! What is up with the really weird bases at the moment? It makes mine seem so boring. Hey, don't shoot me! I'm here to liberate you from the enemies! Me and you are going to be the best of friends as soon as you stop shooting at me. Darn, you have more weapons. I was hoping that would be it. You found an enemy base! No, really? Ooh, sorry base. Thankfully, of course, the base has shields. Ooh, actually, we need to get this guy out of those shields. Let's see if we can shotgun him out. Yes, we can. Yes, we certainly can. All base guardians are down. Congratulations, the base is yours. Also, there's a tiny, tiny little enemy over here. Goodbye. I said goodbye. Thank you. Pop. I'm assuming that was GSO again. Yes, it was, looking at the reputation and by the stuff we're getting. Whoa. So you put the resources here. They get taken up by this piece, which then has some sort of filter system of some kind, which I assume is only allowing... Oh, I see. So the unrefined get looped, and then the refined get taken away. Then up here, I think these are scrappers, so you can put stuff up here to be scrapped. That would be really cool, especially if you use the base magnet, which I actually now have one of, and I really, really need to start using, because they are really helpful. There we are, the block magnet. So when you put that down, it basically sucks up all of the regular items until they're taken up by something else, like the black hole, or by a scrapper. I'm going to keep this around, but I am going to give it some more basic weaponry, just because I noticed those lasers didn't turn, so... This way, it should be able to fight off things pretty much everywhere. We can always come back to it later and set it up properly. All nice and good. Okay, back to killing every tech I can see. Only 10 left. Then we can level up our Hawkeye license and get ourselves some lovely tank tracks. And, of course, all the stuff for a helicopter. Old mobile delivery cannon. Okay, then. I didn't even know you could still get these. And it's sort of weirdly pinked out. I'm assuming that no longer functions, but just in case, we will take it with us. Even if it does look really, really weird right now. Also, only 3 more techs to go, then finally we'll have some new goodies to play with. Well, I'm a derpy derp, which I don't think anyone is overly surprised by, although I am now surprised by my use of the phrase derpy derp. These things at the top here are actually fabricators, not scrappers. And by the looks of things, even when we do reach level 5 with the GSO, we can't create the new cannon anyway, as it normally appears, but it's sort of locked out. At least, I believe that's what happens. Now... This mobile cannon I'm going to store here for the time being. I don't think we can use it. I tried to use it on a bit of scrap I found on the floor, and of course by scrap I mean resource, and nothing actually happened. Hello? You... Honestly, I expected that to be faster than it was. Hawkeye license maxed. Congratulations, you have reached the current maximum license for Hawkeye. There are still new blocks, yeah, we know. Really? Nothing. Ooh. Well, that's a problem. We're maxed out at level 2. Why are we maxed out at level 2 and not 3? Because all of those things wanted level 3. I'm going to Google this. Oh, I am so happy with this. So, although it does say at level 2, I'm actually technically level 3, because as you can see, I can purchase all of the new weapons, including the Karen... The Karen... The Karen... I can purchase Karen, the ultimate weapon. Watch her destroy all things. So we can purchase the Hawkeye Karen turret. The Hawkeye cruise missile, the Hawkeye autocannon, and the Hawkeye seeker pod. And then we can also go ahead and purchase the tank tracks at long last, the wing wheels, which is certainly very, very interesting indeed, and then we can purchase everything over here, including the rotors. Oh, we have so much to do. So what I think we'll do, since this didn't take as long as I expected, is I'm going to go back to base, I'm going to build a new tank using the new weapons and tank tracks, and then next episode, we will dedicate the entire episode to building the flyer of our dreams, because I just don't have long enough tonight to make it worth it. I sadly started recording this after I had just recorded the next From the Depths, which should be coming out on Friday, and, well, it's very, very late at night, hence why I'm stumbling over every single word. Such as, my tank is currently stumbling over everything. It was symbolism. Totally purposeful. First weapon we're going to be testing out is the Hawkeye Seeker Missile Pod. And of course, we've got a full broadside of them. Whoa. Okay, well that is very, very cool. And the reload is nowhere near as bad as I expected. It completely obliterated it. I wonder how good these things are at turning. So let's say I was facing forwards, I want to kill that fellow over there. Okay, I need to be a bit closer apparently. Here? That's not too bad, but definitely best if I face them. So it wouldn't really be too much benefit if I had them on both sides, at least if we were fighting at long range. Also, maybe firing them upwards would be better. Certainly could see these being very good on an aircraft though. In fact, I think that's what they say about them in their description. They are good at ground to air and air to ground, which I certainly see. A little bit derpy, but certainly very fun. Okay, first weapon tested, let's move on to the next. Second weapon, sadly in the dark this time, is the cruise missile. And, oh dear lord, look at that thing. A good test subject, and also a very bad one. Okay, kind of went after the smaller target there, and made it disappear. Much longer reload time. Oh, wow. But, very long range, and absolutely devastating. And we can be so far away, we're probably not going to be in any danger. Okay, if we can fit this thing on a flyer, we've won. We've definitely reached the end game right now. There goes you. Some glorious missiles for you. Yeah, I think I may have found my new favorite weapon. And hello over there. Once I've done testing out all the different things, then we can test out the movement in the form of the tank tracks and make the tank of our dreams. Oh god, that thing's dead. Okay. Really happy with the cruise missiles. It's how long range they are as well. That's ridiculous, especially with how much damage they do. And the cooldown isn't actually as bad as I first thought. It's not good, it's not quick, but certainly packs a punch. Okay, onwards to the next weapon. The next weapon is the Hawkeye autocannon, and one I don't think I'm going to be using. There are two reasons for this. First of all, look at that hitbox. It takes up an immense amount of space, and so you can't use many other guns on the same level as it, and so I don't think I'll use it for much other than maybe on turrets. And the second thing is the noise it makes. If we listen closely once we get a little bit further away from that trading station, like here, and listen. Now, admittedly, a little bit hard to hear over everything else, but it just sounds really weird and I don't like it. Now, things under me, please leave. Thank you. Well, either way though, let's do our testing. So we have two of them, incoming the enemy, and we are now firing. Definitely strong. Quick to turn. The shells have a very high velocity, which is very good at keeping up with the enemy, but no, I don't think it's as good as the missiles, or even just spamming the regular rifles. That took way longer than it should have. Also, I can't wait to have a vehicle with a bit more clearance. Also, really need to clear up this, well, graveyard. Final weapon before we rebuild this vehicle is the Hawkeye cannon turret. So this is a long range cannon which does a lot of damage in a single shot at a very slow fire rate. And there is a little enemy. Hello. Boom. Broke a few blocks. Second shot, a few more blocks. Third shot, a lot of damage. And let's hold down fire so we can see the fire rate. Yeah, that's not too bad, especially at the range capabilities of this weapon. It's not as bad as the chain gun, at least in my opinion, but Is it as good as the missiles and the gun spam? Probably not. However, I could see myself using this as a main weapon, so we have one or maybe two of these at the top, and then gun spam underneath. Also, it looks like a proper cannon turret, which is a very, very good thing indeed. So, I'll be back in just a second. I've now looked at all the weapons. Let's build ourselves a new tank. The first prototype is now ready. We have cruise missiles, we have seeker missiles, we have a load of the regular rifle guns, we even have one of the cannon turrets, and we have a massive internal storage in terms of battery power. We also have a very, very high amount of armor, and we can even get over things now. As you can see, hills are absolutely no problem, and we can even turn on the spot fairly easily. I think this is going to be a very, very powerful vehicle, and it took all of my willpower not to just absolutely spam missiles. Although I am still not overly happy with the cannon turret, so perhaps we'll end up using more cruise missiles. We'll see if it can do well versus larger opponents. For instance, like those. The first prototype is now ready and looking for some action. We have a really high ground clearance, which means we're no longer getting stuck on stuff. We have cruise missiles, we have gun spam at the back and the sides, we have a single one of the larger cannon turrets, and we even have a load of seeker missiles. On the inside, we have a lot of battery power, which means we should be able to do long fights very, very easily. Overall, I'm actually really happy with this build, and it's definitely an upgrade from its previous carnation. Or incarnation. There are words there. I'm sure I'm meant to be using them correctly. Missiles away! It took all of my willpower not to just spam missiles. And I am still tempted to do that. Eventually, we will have a missile spamming tank, but for now, I'm happy with this thing. Those cruise missiles are deadly. I do think changing the top turret for three more cruise missiles would probably be the best, as that way we could just stay at range and just absolutely obliterate our targets. Absolutely no danger to us. How long are the cruise missiles in terms of range? Apparently very, very far. That enemy was just removed from the world. Cruise missiles, maybe a tad overpowered. So, first prototype. Very, very happy, although it did just take some damage to that track. Why? Did I bounce too hard on the train? I think I may have. Trying to force it to happen again. Didn't happen that time. Very curious. Let's find some more fights. Hello there, tiny Hawkeye opponents. Meet cruise missiles. Oh. Well, goodbye. Enemy destroyed, but there are still some more. Look out. Ooh, excellent. And this will also get me some Hawkeye stuff. If I'm lucky, it'll get us some of the propellers, because they're way too expensive. I'm not going to move. I'm going to test out how much battery power this thing actually has. We started off the fight at around about 50%. I'm going to purposefully just put ourselves in the middle of combat. We definitely don't need to do that, considering almost all of our weapons are now long range. I am missing the shotgun, though. Yeah, we have a lot of battery power. And that's it, all enemies destroyed, and the enemy gave us, or at least the loot gave us. Anything of value? No. Not really. Kinda. I will still go ahead and put down a black hole. Once again, I now have shotguns, and everything is right with the world. And apparently we just almost killed an opponent by accident. Hello over there. How are you? We also once again have the black hole generator thing, at least for the time being. Also, this was kind of a sad enemy. Just sort of sat there, getting missiled to death, resigned to its fate. Well, goodbye enemy. Thank you for your money. And I totally meant to take off that gun. back to base after a lot more testing, and I can happily say that this is definitely the best vehicle I've created so far. Only now, after 15 minutes, have my power reserves finally been drained, and I haven't taken a single scratch other than a random bit of damage from falling off a very subtle cliff, which was really kind of annoying. So with that, thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed the video, then of course, likes, favorites, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, shows that Terratech is a series you would like to see continued in the future. In the next episode, we finally build the aircraft of our dreams with missiles and everything good from the Hawkeye faction. So, thank you for watching. And goodbye.